Hi students, welcome to the next session of physics class. So we are discussing units and measurements competitive. In the vectors, resolution of a vector concept we were discussing, isn't it? Resolution of a vector into two components already we discussed, but here in competitive purpose we should come to know more clearly. So therefore we are discussing that one, and example 26 pending is there for us. We will do that one first. We are doing already resolution of a vector. That one I am going to give first. So this is a vector e bar. This is another vector e bar. It is making some angle theta 1. It is making some angle theta 2. So e bar can be resolved into two components. One is along x axis. Another one is along y-axis. What we discussed, which is basing the side, that is going to become a cos theta. So remaining side, this one is going to become a sin theta. This is a bar we resolve. Now b bar. B bar along this, along x-axis. Now this one will become b cos theta 2. This one will become b sin theta 2. So which is basing angle? How to resolve? Up to now we resolve only one vector. Now we resolve two vectors. Like that n number of vectors we give also we can resolve. So this is the main concept. This is a vector a bar. This is making angle theta. So this is going to become a cos theta. This is going to become a sin theta. So horizontal component, vertical component we will say. If you add these two again you should get a bar. That one will be using vector form. A bar is equal to a cos theta I cap plus a sin theta j cap. A cos theta is along x axis. Therefore we will multiply with I cap. So we will multiply with j cap. Here I cap and j cap are the unit vectors. The third one is there. Z axis, then that one is k cap. So how one is there in mathematics? If you multiply any number with 1, its value will not be changing. Same like that. So in vectors we will say unit vector. Unit vector magnitude is 1. If you multiply unit vector with any scalar quantity, that is going to become vector. So therefore a cos theta is scalar. To convert into vector we will multiply with I cap. If you multiply with I cap means that is along x axis. J cap means that is along y axis. K cap means that is along z axis. Okay. What is the magnitude from this one? Will write simply ax I cap plus ay j cap. If three dimensional vector means z axis is also there. At that time, how will write this one? A bar is equal to a cos theta I cap plus means ax, ay, az. Okay. So this theta is making along x axis. So at the time, so this theta can be written as in terms of alpha, beta, gamma. This vector is making some angle with theta, some angle theta with x axis. Some angle theta with y axis, isn't it? So in three dimensional, so a vector a bar is making alpha with y axis, alpha with x axis, beta with y axis, and gamma z axis. Gamma with z axis. At the time, how we will write this one? Here what is ax we wrote here? A cos theta. Like that, ax equal to a cos alpha, because alpha is meeting the x axis. Always which is basing angle, that side is going to become cos. Okay, next ay. Ay means this one. This is basing which angle? Beta. Therefore a cos beta. Like that, az, a cos gamma. So now if you write in vector form, ax i cap plus ay j cap plus a z k cap. So this cos alpha, what we write, cos alpha is equal to a x by a, cos theta is equal to a y by a, cos gamma is equal to a z by a. Here cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, they gave named as directional cosines. So name of this one, cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, directional cosines. This one you will be coming to know in mathematics also. They will discuss this one. At that time you can you will be coming to know very well. Cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. Sometimes they call directional cosines. If you square on that, they give one value there. Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to ax square by a square, ay square by az square. How much you will get means you will get 1. Sometimes they will ask this one only direct equation in options. Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma value. Like the sin square alpha, sin square beta, sin square gamma also they will ask. So from this you have to change. Sin square alpha plus cos square alpha equal to how much? 1. You can put it in mathematics. Sin square alpha plus cos square alpha equal to 1. Substitute cos square alpha much 1 minus sin square alpha, 1 minus sin square beta, 1 minus sin square gamma. You will get sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma. What is sin square? Cos square alpha, 1 minus sin square. Substitute here 1 minus sin square alpha plus 1 minus sin square beta plus 1 minus sin square gamma equal to 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1. How much? 3. Minus minus minus. Therefore, 3 minus sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma equal to this minus. You can bring this here. 3 minus 1 equal to sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma. Then sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma equal to 2. So cos square beta, cos square gamma means 1. Sin square beta, sin square gamma means 2. So these are called directional cosines. In problems we are going to get those. So this is about resolution of a vector into two components. Always horizontal component means which is basic angle that is going to become cos, remaining angle that is going to become sin. So now I am going to give a vector for c bar. So this is basic angle theta. Then resolve this one into two component means this is one component c cos theta, this is one component c sin. Very simple. Which is basic, that one is going to become cos theta. Okay. So next we will see example 26. So see the example 26. A particle is moving along a circle with a uniform speed 10 meter per second. At time t is equal to 0, the particle is moving along east. Find the change in velocity, both magnitude and direction they are asking. So both magnitude and direction they are asking. In 1/4 revolution, half revolution, 3/4 revolution, so 1 revolution. Okay. So first we will see uniform speed. Uniform speed in circular path. So this is circular path. Uniform speed at all speed, at all points, it is moving with constant velocity. The velocity how much they gave you? 10 meter per second. So next, at a time t is equal to 0, the particle is moving along east. East means will be coming from direction. So east, west, north, south. Towards east means like this, in forward direction, like this. In this direction, it is going. If it is moving like this, anti-clockwise. Okay, where the east is coming, here means it is like this, towards west. Here means towards south. Here means towards north. Here means towards east. Now initially particle is here. Whether this is V1 or U, you can take. So in this direction with what velocity? 10 meter per second. So in A they are asking how we have taken initially it is moving means now this is towards east direction. At the time initially particle is moving towards east. Next, first one they are asking for half revolution. What is the change in velocity, both magnitude and direction? They ask. Half revolution means from where to where it is moving. Half revolution means from bottom to quarter. Sorry, half or one fourth. See, first one they give 1/4. First one they give 1/4. B they give half revolution. C they give 3/4. D they give 1/3. Correct only. So first we'll see 1/4 revolution. 1/4 means this total is circle means up to here this is half. Now it is A. And this is B. This is C. So this is D. Now object is moving. It is going up to B. Going up to B means this is 1/4. Up to C means half. Up to D means 3/4. Up to A means 1/3. Okay. Now this is at B. At B means to get the direction. What you have to write? Tangent. So if object is moving in circular path, if you have given tangent means the tangent gives the direction of the velocity. Now here B draws how much? 10 only. Right? Because it is moving with uniform velocity. Now what is the change in magnitude? Change in magnitude means delta B is equal to what is the formula? V2 minus V1 is vector rotation. We should write. Now this vectors I am drawing. So one vector like this, V1. So another vector like this, V2. So this vector direction should be in opposite direction, means in this direction. Then only we can find magnitude. We can't find resultant of these two. How we will find means like this. Already we discussed this one, P bar. Like this we can find. This is resultant, isn't it? So yes, this is tail, this is head. So head should be like this. We cannot find resultant of these two. So for our convenience, what we will do, without changing the magnitude, we will change the direction. If we change the direction, this is going to become minus V1, isn't it? So now, same vector I am drawing like this, and this is going to become minus V1. This vector remains like this one, V2. Now, what is the result? It means, this is the result, delta V. Delta V is equal to V2 minus V1. V2 minus V1 means here, V2 plus minus V1. How to find the resultant of these two means we came from. Both are perpendicular. Therefore, what is the formula? P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos 90. Cos 90 0. Therefore, so we will write root V2 square plus V1 square. General formula you have to write like this. Resultant is equal to V2 square plus minus V1 square plus 2V2 minus V1 cos 90. Because angle between these two vectors is 90. So this is the resultant. Alpha you can take or theta you can take. So cos 90, 0. So V2 square plus V1 square. Root 10 square plus 10 square. So 2 times of 10 square. So root 2, 10. Or 10 root 2, remainder per seconds. So this is magnitude. Direction means 10 alpha over. 10 alpha means V2 by V1. So tan alpha is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, V2 by V1. Then what you will get? Tan alpha is equal to V2 by V1. 10 by 10. 10 by 10 means 1. So tan alpha 1 means 10 45 degrees 1. Therefore alpha is how much? 45. Or theta is equal to 45. Okay. Next up, B. So what is B means? Half revolution. Half revolution means, so where the object is here? At C. At C, what is the direction? You have to draw tangent. This is nothing but 10 meter per second. Now that one we are taking it as V2. At A, V1. At C, V2. So now again you have to draw. I am not drawing this diagram once again there. So V1 is like this, V2 is like this. So this is V1. So this is V2. So both are in opposite direction. So opposite direction means what is the change in velocity formula? Both are in opposite direction. V1 minus V2. So V2 minus V1 means, so minus of minus. Isn't it? Correct one. Minus of minus. Delta V is equal to. So this is V1. So this is weak.
So both are in opposite. Therefore, if you have taken, so this one minus.
So V2 minus V1.
V2 minus V1 means V2 value
minus V2.
V1 value minus.
So minus 10 minus. So minus 20 meters.
So this minus is indicating, so object is moving, resultant direction is in this direction. In this direction means like this. This minus you got. Minus we have taken in this direction means towards
west.
So change in velocity is towards west direction. Correct only? So 20 meter per second, change in velocity 20 meter per second. So in that they gave only 20. Okay. So this minus indicating, so change in velocity is in westwards. Towards west. Next. C means so object is tangent we are drawing. C means we are finding here 3/4. 3/4 means here. So again we are getting same like A only. So one velocity is like this, one velocity is like this. Like A only you will get, then root 2 theta r 45. Both will be same only. Small change will be coming. Here resultant velocity vector thing like this. Here you can try to so V1 is like this, V2 is like this. So this is the result. Again you will get same like A only. Then root 2. Resultant direction is 45. I will say what is the direction of this one. Next, last one. So last one they gave. One revolution. So one revolution means the object is at which point? So object is at D. Sorry, A. So it is starting at A. Again it is coming and reaching A. So V1 also like this, V2 also like this. Both are in the same direction. Therefore, what you have to do? Change in velocity means you have to add V2 plus V1. So that will get, sorry, change in velocity means V2 minus V1. So both are in same direction. So 10 minus 10, so 0 meter per second. So because change in velocity is 0. 0 meter per second because both are coming into the same direction. So V2 minus V1. See this direction and this direction I am going to give her. Here resultant direction how we got at B?
Like this.
At D we got
like this.
What are these directions? Two is. So direction means you have to take this one. This is east, northeast, northwest. Isn't it? This direction is southeast, southwest. So this came like this. Like this means which direction?
Northwest.
Like this it came means which direction?
Southeast.
So this direction is southeast. This direction is northwest. So just how to take the directions I am saying. So perpendicular means north, east, west, south, we will say. If it is coming like this means northwest. Resultant direction because they ask that one also. So here delta V is equal to V2 minus V1. So both are in same direction. Therefore, both are positive only. 10 minus 10 we are getting 0 meter per second. Change in velocity I am saying. Change in velocity is 0 at initial point after one revolution. Next they give position vector. Position vector. What is position vector? The vector with 3 is representing the position of an object. If object is moving in a plane, so let us assume 2-dimensional plane. So along x axis, y axis. So object reaches here. This is point. Draw two normals. Assume this is x, this is y. Now point P is x, y. That one only we will write it as vector
r bar is equal to xi cap plus y j cap.
So along x axis what is the position? X. Along y axis what is the position? Y. R bar is representing position vector of the object. Here position x y. How we will get means? So where we are? Initial now we are at home. If you are in college means we are in college. In college where we are?
So you will be in particular room. In that particular room, where you are? Particular bench. In that particular bench, where you are? Some particular position. That one only your position along x-axis, y-axis. Okay. So if your object will be having position vector in your home also for fan. Fan will be having position vector. You can draw. So you will be getting x-axis, y-axis, xi cap plus yi cap. If it is three-dimensional, you will get in addition z, k cap. Here they will give x comma y comma z. So now a point A, x comma y comma z, or x1 comma y1 comma z1. Another point B, x2 comma y2 comma z2. What is the position of this one means A bar or OA bar if they have taken from origin. OA bar is equal to x1 I cap plus x2 j cap plus x, sorry, x1 y1 z bar. So here B bar is equal to x2 I cap plus y2 j cap plus z2 k cap. Just two positions they get, x1 y1 z1, x2 y2 z. How to write in vector form means like this will be. This is called position vector of an object. Okay. Next, addition or subtraction of vectors, component approach. Component approach means for our convenience, we are going to divide F1 into two components, F2 into two components, and F3 also if possible we will divide. So this is XY. XY plane means you will be getting two components. XYZ planes you will get three components. So XY plane, therefore F1 can be divided into two components. F2 can be divided into two components. Okay. So in the component F1, one component will be along x-axis, another component along y-axis. Just this one they gave example. By using this, we will solve the problems. We have to understand this one very carefully, very, very important. So this will be coming till the end of second year. Okay, this method. So this is F1 one vector. If you resolve this one into two components along x-axis, this component F1, which one will be coming? Cos alpha, sin alpha. So F1 cos alpha. What I told you, which is basing angle, that side is going to become cos alpha. So which is not facing, so that one is going to become F1 sin alpha. Next, this one, F2. So F2 which is basing, that is going to become F2 cos beta. So along this edge, what will become in F2 sin beta. If you are seeing F3, F3 is already along which axis? Y-axis. Therefore, you don't need to divide this one. If it is in plane like this by making some angle, then only you have to divide into two components. A vector which is along x-axis, you can't divide into two components because already it is acting along only one component. F3 we cannot divide. But F3 is along which axis? Y-axis. Okay. Now, see here. F1 cos alpha, F2 cos beta. So, all x-axis you can write in one. So one is like this, another one is like this. Both are in opposite direction. Then how we will write F x? So both are along x axis means F x is F x. I told you how many components you will get. Two components you will get. One is along x axis, another one is along y axis. So along x axis you can write, so F1 cos alpha minus F2 cos beta, or F2 cos beta minus F1 cos alpha. That is our wish, how we are writing. Okay. F1 cos alpha minus F2 cos beta. Any one you can follow. Just I wrote like this, we will follow this one. If it is going to be alternated, how it is the, what is the value also, we will see. What is the problem, we will see. No problem you will get. So this is only, you can do either this minus this or this minus. So whenever it is coming for problem got, how we have to subtract I will say. Next, Fy. So Fy means along y axis. Here both the vectors in same direction. Means you have to add these two. Isn't it? F1 sin alpha plus F2 sin alpha. Why? Because both the vectors in same direction, arrow marks. This arrow mark is up. So this sum minus this one we have to write. That is nothing but F1 sin alpha plus F2 sin beta. Both are added because both are in same direction. Now minus this one, minus F3. Okay, so always we have to take whenever it is coming for problem what? More minus less, bigger value minus smaller value. So that one fx, fy you got. Now, so what is the resultant? Resultant means f is equal to root fx square plus fy square, because x and y always perpendicular. This is nothing but resultant. And if you want to find angle, fy, fx. So this is the procedure to solve the problems. Now they gave one problem for us, we will solve that. See the next problem, example 27. Find the resultant of the following forces. Here they gave one force 5 newton, 10 newton, 3 newton. How we will come to this is force means, because force unit is newton. They gave 37, 53, therefore these values they only give. Sometimes they won't give, you should remember sin 37 cos 37, sin 53 cos 53. Sometimes they won't give these values because we are doing first time, therefore you don't know. After completion of second year, you should remember these values also. How to resolve these vectors? Same method you can follow. So which is basing, this one is going to become how much? 5 cos 37. So if you resolve this one into, so this one we are going to get 5 sin 37. So 5 newtons we divide. Now we will see 10 newtons. 10 newtons. This is basic. Therefore, this one is going to become 10 cos 53. Next. This one is going to become 10 sin 53. So finally we will be getting only two components. One component is along x-axis, another component is along y-axis. Fx we are going to find. Fx we are going to find means 5 cos 37, 10 cos 53. Cos 37 value how much? Cos 37 4 by 5. So therefore this value is 5 into 4 by 5. That is nothing but 4. So cos 53 value how much? Cos 53 3 by 5. So 10 into 3 by 5. That is nothing but 6. Now which is more here? 6 is more. 6 minus 4. 2. So this is fx. So what is the resultant direction means? So in this direction you can take. Why? Because 6 is more, more minus is. Therefore, resultant direction. These two directions is like this. If you want to take the wrong direction, component direction. Next, fy. Fy is, here two components are there. You have to add these two. First, so sin 53 how much? Sin 53, 4 by 5. So this one, 10 into 4 by 5. 2 times 8. So 10 sin 53 value 8. 5 sin 37 value. 5 into sin 37 how much? 3 by 5. 3. So 8 plus 3. So this is 8, this is 3. 8 plus 3. Minus. So this is already 3 there. This one we will need to resolve. Minus 3. So therefore, resultant is 8. So fx you got, fy you got. Then what you have to find? Resultant of the so resultant is tan theta. See here, they gave here 8 also. I didn't draw the 8 units. They gave in this direction 1 8. Okay. So without 8, what we did is correct. But they gave 8 newtons also along x-axis. 8 newtons they gave means 5 cos 37 value 4. This is 8. So 8 plus 4. Because in this along x-axis you will be having 2 values. One is 8, another one is 4. Therefore total is here 12. So 12. So this value how much you got? 6. Therefore 12 minus 6. Now this resultant direction is like this. Why? Because more minus less, which is having more value in the direction resultant will be there. So this is more. In this, this is more. Therefore, it will be like this. So fx is 6, fy is 8. This is fx direction, this is fy direction. Now resultant force f is equal to root of fx square plus fy square. 6 square plus 8 square. 6 square plus 8 square how much? 36 plus 64 root 100. So resultant force is 10 newtons. So if they want resultant direction,
So resultant direction means it is making angle theta. Tan theta is equal to Fyy Fx. Fy value 8 by 6. So 4 tos 4 by 3.
Tan theta 4 by 3 means what is theta value?
So what is tan theta here? Sin theta by cos theta. Sin theta by cos theta.
Value how much you got?
4 by 3.
Here.
Sin 37 by cos 37. How much you got? 3 by 5 by 4 by 5. Means you will get 3 by 4. 3 by 4 you will get. Next, see here. Sin 53 by cos 53. 4 by 5 by 3 by 5. 5 by 5 will be cancel. 4 by 3 will get. Therefore, sin 53 cos 53. That is nothing but theta value how much means 53 degrees. So, resultant direction is 53 degrees. This is how to resolve. See the next problem. Example 28. What is again in 28? If the resultant of the following forces is 0, find the value of F now. So if you find resultant, that value is going to become 0. This one you can do in two ways. So if you resolve this one into two components, this one you will get F naught basing 30, therefore cos that. So this one F naught sin that. So resultant is 0 means, so this minus this and this minus this. So if you substitute in this formula, you will get 0. Now if you have taken this one along x axis, fx is equal to, so f naught cos 30 minus 2 root 3. Like that, fy. Now you get in these two directions are, that is nothing but f naught sin 30 plus 2 minus 4. So resultant is going to be 0 means f is equal to root of fx square plus fy square is going to become 0. Substitute these two values, fx value and the fy value, here you will get f naught. So what is fx value? F naught cos 30. Cos 30 value how much? Root 3 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. Cos 30 root 3 by 2 only. So root 3 by 2. So substitute here. F naught into root 3 by 2 minus 2 root 3. Here F naught by 2 plus 2 minus 4. So substitute here. Square will be coming. F naught root 3 by 2 minus 2 root 3 whole square. Whole square. Plus Fy value. So you can add this now. F naught by 2 minus 2. So F naught by 2 minus 2 whole square equal to 0. Because the resultant force is going to become 0. So you can take common squaring on both sides. 0 square. So you can remove square. Then what will be remaining here? F naught root 3 by 2 minus 2 root 3 whole square plus F naught by 2 minus 2 whole square. So you can apply A minus B whole square, A minus B whole square. Just you have to add, you will be getting F naught value. This is one method. Another method is, so if resultant vector is 0, magnitude is 0, either AX, AY, AZ, all are going to become 0. All are going to become 0 means, so this fx is going to be 0. That is nothing but f naught cos 30 minus 2 root 3 is going to become 0. This is another method I am saying. So then we can do directly. So f naught root 3 by 2 equal to 2 root 3. So f naught equal to 4 newtons. If you solve like this also, you will get 4. If you solve like this also, you will get 4. Once you can check, so both the methods will be correct. Okay. Next is example 29. A particle moves 30 meters north, then 20 meters east, and finally 30 root 2 meters southwest. Find the displacement of the particle. So directions are important here. East, west, north, south. So first particle is moving 30 meters north. 30 meters north means in upward direction. Upward direction means actually it is like this. So 30 meters along now. Next, they give 20 meters east from here. 20 meters east towards like this. Next, this is northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest. So they gave 30 root to southwest. Southwest means this direction. Northeast means this direction. Southwest means this direction. Means in this direction. So in this direction, 30 root to north. southwest angle. So this angle is going to become. So this angle is going to become 45 degrees. They are asking total displacement. What is the total? This is along y-axis. This is along x-axis. Therefore, 30 and 20 we cannot divide. We have to divide 30 root. 30 root can be divided into two components. One is along this component. Another one is along this component. Okay. So first we will see 30 root to this component. Which is basing angle here? This is basing angle. Therefore, this one is going to become 30 root to cos 45. This one is going to become 30 root to sin 45. Correct only? So 30 root to cos 45. Cos 45 value how much? 1 by root 2. Sin 45 also 1 by root 2. Therefore, so this is acting like this, this is acting like this. So 20 minus this one. So along x component. X component you are getting 20 minus 30 root 2 cos 45. This is also like this. Towards north, like this. This is coming down. Therefore, y component is nothing but. So 30 minus 30 root 2 sin 45. So 20 minus 30 root 2. Cos 45 how much? 1 by root 2. 20 minus 30. Minus 10 you got. Here, 30 minus 30 root 2. Sin 45 also 1 by root 2. This one, 30 minus 30, 0. So, only x is there. So, resultant means we will find resultant displacement r is equal to tau x square plus y square. That is nothing but minus 10 whole square plus 0. So, you will get 10 meters. This is distance. But they ask displacement. Displacement means with the negative sign also you should take. So, here y is going to be 0, only x component. Only x along x axis it is moving. Along x axis. Along x axis minus 10 meters you got. Minus 10 meters you got means in this direction towards west. That minus is indicating towards west. If you find this is magnitude, if we wrote with minus 10, so that is with direction we are going to give minus 10 meters along this direction west. So that is about resolving components. Very, very important model. Still, second to you, this type of problems we are going to get. So, our next topic is vector product. So, product of two vectors. They will give two vectors. You will be having product of vectors in two ways. One is if the product is giving scalar. Sometimes, if you product two vectors, sometimes it will be coming scalar. Sometimes it will be coming vector. Just if you multiply two numbers, 2 into 3, 6. So numbers if you are giving product means one number will be coming. But here two vectors we are producting means sometimes vector will come, sometimes scalar will come. So the product of two vectors equal to scalar. So that one you are getting scalar, we are calling it as scalar product. So after producting two vectors, we got vector means that one we are calling it as vector product. So first they gave here scalar product. So scalar product. This one only they will say dot product. So name only is saying scalar product means if you product two vectors, what is coming? Scalar is coming. So another name of this one is dot product. So this one will be helpful for our work energy power lesson. We are going to define work by using this concept only. Okay. So therefore again, we will recall that work energy power, work definition whenever we are giving, we are going to recall. So we can't give examples presently because in our concept it came now, therefore only we are discussing. So examples we will give later because you don't know work, power, energy, all these presently. So scalar product means they give two vectors, A bar, B bar, two vectors they give.
A bar and B bar. If you product means, so A bar dot B bar. That is nothing but C. C bar you should not know, right? Because C is resultant of these two vectors, product is giving scalar. Therefore, scalar will not have direction. Therefore, C is equal to A bar dot B bar. Okay. So, how we will write this one? A bar dot B bar means AB cos theta. This one will be right, A bar dot B bar is equal to AB cos theta. This one, how we will define, we will see. Here A is magnitude of A bar, B is magnitude of B bar. So in textbook or any book, whenever they are writing vector, they will write like this. A. This is vector. This one they will write, it means very thick letter. But here we can't do that one like this, therefore we will write bar, we will write. Instead of writing like this, we will write A bar. Instead of writing like this, we will write B bar. If you wrote AB like this, this is nothing but magnitude of A bar. Magnitude of A bar means they will write modulus of A bar. Here both will be same, both will be same. In textbook you can't see bars, only thick letter they will write. That is the difference. Whenever we are writing on the board or notes, we will write like this. This is also like this. Okay. So modulus A bar, modulus B bar, cos. What is A here? Magnitude of A bar. What is B here? Magnitude of B bar. So product of magnitude of two vectors and cosine of angle between them. So it is defined as scalar. Definition of this one. Product of magnitude of two vectors and cosine of angle between them. This is one way of giving the definition. Another way. Another way means, if you have taken this is A bar, this is B bar. Angle between these two vectors is theta. If you resolve this one into two components, this component is going to become B cos theta. So, how B cos theta component means along first vector. So, magnitude of means one of the component, B cos theta, B sin theta. Out of these two components, which component you are taking? B cos theta. Okay. So, one of the component of second vector in the direction of first vector. So, B cos theta is one of the component along which direction? A bar direction. Instead of taking A bar, B bar, we will say first vector, second vector. Component of, one of the component of second vector in the direction of first vector. Okay, so here B cos theta is one of the component. A is first vector magnitude, B cos theta is one of the component of the second vector in the direction of first vector. That much big name is there for B cos theta. So this is another definition. The product of magnitude of first vector and component of B cos theta is nothing but one of the component. One of the component, because every vector will be having in plane, two dimensional plane, two components. So B cos theta, B sin theta. We are not taking B sin theta, we are taking B cos theta. So product of magnitude of one vector, first vector, and one of the component of second vector in the direction of first vector. This B cos theta is there in the direction of first vector. That one only we can write in another way, that is nothing but B A cos theta. This is also same. Now see, so product of magnitude of second vector and one of the component of first vector. Now this one is in which direction? In the direction of second vector. And now we are dividing like this, it will be coming. This is A bar. So this is B bar. If you divide this one will be coming A cos theta. So this is the definition of scalar product. So A B cos theta. In this you don't need to remember definition presently. Only try to remember this equation. A bar B bar is equal to A B cos theta. If you remember this equation, so that is enough for this topic. Okay. Next, if this value is changing, theta is 0, theta is 180, theta is 90, what is going to happen? They give 1/1. If cos 0. Theta is 0 means cos 0 value 1. Then product is going to become magnitude. C is equal to AB. Cos 90. If vector product between this is A bar, this is B bar. So angle is 90. At the time, dot product is going to become how much? Cos 90 value how much? 0. Therefore,
a bar dot b bar is equal to 0. So two vectors dot product or scalar product is going to become 0 when two vectors are in perpendicular direction, or both vectors are perpendicular means, so resultant is going to become, means resultant scalar product is going to become 0. Next, angle between two vectors. Angle between two vectors means sometimes they will be A and B value, they will ask theta. How you will find means? So A bar dot B bar is equal to AB cos theta. Then cos theta is equal to A bar dot B bar by AB. So for this A bar, for B bar, and A value, B values are different. So A bar means, I will give an example. A bar means AX I cap plus AY J cap. B bar means BX I cap plus BY J cap. For this, what is A? Magnitude of A. That is nothing but root AX square plus AY square. Magnitude of B. Root BX square plus B y square. So what is the angle theta means? You have to substitute A bar dot B bar here. A bar dot B bar by A. A means this one, magnitude of A bar. B means magnitude of B bar. So this is A bar dot B bar. Okay. If you substitute means, how it will be coming? This time giving. So A bar dot B bar. So AX BX AY BY is divided by root of AX square plus AY square BX square plus BY square. How this one came, you will understand after completion of our next topic. That is nothing but I cap dot I cap, J cap dot J cap. Once again, I will write this one. Just how we are going to find theta, we are giving. This is the main equation. This is the main equation. In this one, we got from this equation. Okay. So, try to remember this equation. Remaining one by one slowly, it will come. So after product of it came, I am going to explain, see carefully. So you will be having unit vectors along x axis, y axis, z axis. I cap, j cap, another one is k cap. So what is the angle between these two means? 90 degrees. Why? Because I cap along x axis, j cap along y axis, k cap along z axis, like this. Okay, if you give three fingers like this, I cap, j cap, k cap. Okay, so angle between these three fingers? 90 degrees. Therefore, IJ, IK, KI, so all these will be angle 90 degrees. So if you are substituting I cap dot I cap. I cap dot I cap means according to this formula. I cos theta. A bar dot B bar means AB cos theta. Therefore, I cap dot I cap means I cos theta. So I means magnitude of I cap. Here I cap is unit vector. Unit vector magnitude how much? 1. Therefore, 1 into theta. Both I is in same direction. I. So both I is in same direction. Therefore theta is 0. Cos 0? 1. Therefore I cap dot I cap value how much you got? 1. Same like that. J cap dot J cap equal to 1. Same like that. K cap dot K cap also equal to 1. Next we will see I cap dot J cap. I cap dot J cap means I J cos theta according to this formula. A B cos theta. So I J cos theta. So I J value is 1 because both are unit vectors. Theta is how much here? Angle between I and J. So I J K, angle between I and J is 90. Therefore cos 90. 0. So therefore I cap dot J cap dot K cap dot I cap is equal to 0. So by using this concept, we got numerator value like this. Now we are going to do AX I cap plus AY J cap. This is A bar. B bar is equal to BX I cap plus BY J cap. So dot product A bar dot B bar is equal to, so AX I cap plus AY J cap dot BX I cap plus BY J cap. So normally you will multiply na same like that. Now AX I cap is multiplied with BX I cap plus BY J cap. So AX I cap into BX I cap Next again plus ax I cap into by j cap. Now ax with these two over. Now again ay with these two plus ay j cap into bx I cap plus ay j cap into by j cap. See here.
I cap into I cap how much? 1. Therefore, ax into bx, ax, bx. I cap into j cap how much? I cap not j cap. I cap not j cap is 0. Therefore, this term is going to become 0. And j cap into I cap, this term is going to become 0. Therefore, we are getting ay, by. You know, you need to do always like this. Whenever they give dot product, simply you can multiply. If they give third vector, az, k cap, bz, k cap. Then again you will get here az plus bz. This is the dot product of two vectors. See the next one they gave, component of a bar along b bar. This is nothing but component of b bar along a bar. That is nothing but b cos theta. Component of b bar along a bar is b cos theta means component of a bar along b cos theta is a cos theta. Isn't it? A cos theta. If here it is b means you will get here b cos theta. A cos theta is equal to a cos theta value. Cos theta equation how much you got? Cos theta is equal to a bar dot b bar by ab. So a bar dot b bar by ab. They will ask in problems. There will be two vectors, any one vector along b bar. So a cos theta means you have to write a into cos theta value this form. If they ask b bar along a bar means you have to write b cos theta. Okay. So now this a will be cancelled. So a bar dot b bar by b. Unit vector definition you remember. So unit vector b cap is equal to b bar by b. Therefore, this one will write as a bar dot b cap. Otherwise, remember like this one. So component of a bar along b bar, how we got a bar dot b cap. If they ask component of b bar along a cap, how you get here? So b bar dot a cap. Okay. So now see, this is only component of a bar along b bar, a bar dot b cap. Now they are asking vector component means for this component, component is scalar quantity. So this one you should multiply with one unit vector, then it is going to become. But the unit vector along which direction? B bar direction, not along x axis, y axis. X axis means what we will be, x axis means this one we should multiply with I cap. Along y axis means j cap. But here they ask vector component of a bar along which axis? Means along which vector? B bar. Therefore, with which unit vector we should multiply? B cap. Therefore, vector component is going to become, how it is going to become means a cos theta into b cap. What is a cos theta value? Not a bar dot b cap into b cap. Simply should multiply with that unit vector. If they ask component of b bar along a bar, then you will get here b bar dot a cap. Vector component of b bar along a bar, then you will get here b bar dot a cap into a cap. Okay. Next we will see remaining tomorrow.